Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel named Learning to Learn. So today we are going to discuss about business economics, and I brought notes also, right? So these are the notes, as you can see. And if you want this notes, guys, please do one thing: join Telegram and search this particular name, right? You will find this particular channel, and on this channel I'll be uploading the notes as soon as I upload the video, so that you can keep these notes in handy for ready reference. Okay, so make sure you do that so that you can get the notes, as well as you can join my two different channels named Study Vlog and I'm really sorry the gap was so long. Okay, the Study Vlog and Boss Lady, but these channels are for self-improvement, self-development. It is not like a time pass channel where I will upload any funny videos or something like that. No, it's total productive channels that will ultimately help you somewhere or the other. Like in Study Vlog, I am uploading videos of how to make YouTube videos, you should start a YouTube video or not, various ideas on YouTube videos, etc. And on Boss Lady, I am trying to upload videos on the topic personality development and how to look presentable in the office, how to give presentations, etc. That is totally related to your personality development and growth. So all these channels will ultimately help you somewhere or the other in your career, in your life, in your success, etc. Now let's move on to one more important update: Unacademy. Yes, anybody who's not on Unacademy, please join Unacademy. You'll get enormous number of benefits, and I usually give special classes on Unacademy. Right now I'm giving special classes on economics, and after a day or so I'll start with marketing. So make sure you can join. And my classes, the free classes, are usually at 7:30 to 8:30 in the evening, as well as you can join the plus course, which is a paid course. If you are preparing for NTA UGC NET, I teach almost around 4 hours daily for paper 1 and paper 2 commerce of NTA UGC NET. So make sure you do check out Unacademy at least once, so that you at least you can see the free content which is available. Now moving on to our today's topic, that is business economics, right? So this is the notes, as you can see, I have prepared. Fine, so if you need this notes, the scan copy will be available on Telegram. Fine, so first of all, what is business economics, right? This I have already discussed in the previous video, so we'll just have an overview and then we'll move forward. The same video will be available in Hindi, so don't worry about that. So business economics, what do you mean by economics, right? So let me just adjust the camera a bit. Okay, great, now it looks fine. So what do you mean by business economics? Business economics is derived from the Greek word oikonomics, where oikos means household and norms means management, right? So the economics can be said as management of households in the Greek language. But what do we understand by business economics? Business economics is made up of two words: business plus economics. Business is decision making capacity and moving forward, planning, etc. It means to keep a person busy, right? Why do you do business? To gain profit. Fine. Economics is how to allocate scarce resources to satisfy their unlimited wants. Human have unlimited wants, and to satisfy those unlimited wants, what do? They use resources like land, labor, machinery, capital, raw material, etc., and to maximize their satisfaction. Okay, so what economics here means that you use various scarce resources, limited resources, to satisfy your ultimate unlimited wants, so that you can gain the maximum benefit or maximum satisfaction. That is economics, right? So if we combine these two words, that is business and economics, what are we going to get? Business economics. Okay, business economics is the study that how an individual or firm uses its limited resources to satisfy its unlimited wants. Okay, as simple jo abhi upar bola tha, same to same hai. Okay, next, business economics is the application of economic theory and quantitative methods to the managerial decision making process. So when the management makes decisions, right, so there are many economic theories and economic quantitative methods to be considered before taking that absolute decision, right? So if I can say in simple words, application of economics in the business is called business economics, right? So this would be very simple for you guys. Now let us understand one more simple thing and then I would end this particular video. Now let us start with economic problems. Because we have just studied that what is economics. Economics is using of scarce resources or limited resources to satisfy your unlimited wants. That is economics, right? So what is economic problems? Now, economic problem is a problem of choice. Choice we are talking about. Involving satisfaction of unlimited wants out of limited resources having alternative uses. Yes, we have just discussed this thing that what humans are doing. Humans are trying to satisfy their unlimited wants by using limited and scarce resources. And these resources have alternative uses. Means you can use it either for one thing or other thing, not all at once. For example, you have land. Either you can grow fruits or vegetables, or you can build a property. You cannot do both. You cannot do both. That is alternative use. Means either you can use a particular thing in this way or that way. You cannot use in both ways. So resources being limited and having alternative uses, there comes these three basic problems. That is called scarcity of resources. You have very limited resources, right? Then unlimited human wants. The human wants are unlimited. And alternative uses. All the resources have different uses. So what is scarcity of resources? Resources which includes land, labor, capital, etc. And these resources are limited as compared to their demand, right? As suppose I need a lot of capital for investment, but I cannot get because that is a limited resource, right? Unlimited human wants. Yes, human wants are unlimited. A human can never be satisfied, right? Human wants can never be fully satisfied and they differ in priorities. Yes, this is very important. Priorities means I would choose something rather than the other thing, and you might choose the same thing rather than the other thing. It means I give priority to something and you might give priority to something else. That is also allowed. For example, I don't like curd. I don't eat curd. Anytime, any point of time, I cannot have curd, right? That is my choice. But the same thing will not happen to you. You might like curd. Curd in Hindi, we say dahi, right? So that's your choice. Now, unlimited human wants is, yes, these are not limited, right? And that too, they differ in priorities. The last but not the least of having such economic problems is alternative uses. Resources can be put to various different uses, right? So these are the three reasons of generating this basic economic problem, and only to satisfy or to solve this particular economic problem, we have to study economics. Only to solve this particular economic problem. Right, now the two important words used in this terms in this page are alternative and scarce. Alternative here means available as another possibility or another use, right? So you can use various alternatives or various options, you can say. Scarce means shortage of goods and resources, means it is limited. You don't have abundant quantity, you have a limited quantity, right? So that is called scarce. So this was the video for today, guys. We basically understood what is economics again, and we understood what are economic problems. Fine. So this would be helpful for all those who are giving their 11th class examinations. Then someone in BCom, someone in MCom, someone in MBA, someone who wants to learn economics for the first time, etc. So I hope you have understood this video. If there are any doubts, any problem, please do tell me. I'll try to help you out. And I'm uploading various other topics, so make sure you also watch the series. And if I can show you, I made a lot of notes recently, right? So actually I have started a series for financial management. Yes, So this is the basic image of financial management, right? And suppose on Telegram you get notes and you are getting confused that which one is this. I have made a course here, FM01 means financial management 01, and for economics I have written ECO, economics 01. So you'll able to find it properly page wise so that you don't miss any notes, okay? As well as you can also join the other two channels which I have mentioned above, right? At the starting of the video. And if there are any problems, any doubts, please do tell me. I'll try to help you out. Take good care of yourself, study hard, and bye bye.